SVD Spirituality. How does the spirituality of our founder, Saint Arnold Johnson, help us to develop a spirituality for our times? Spirituality is that which gives meaning to one's life and draws one to transcend oneself. Spirituality is a way of life on which the spirit leads me to the fullness of life in the basic relationships to myself, to God, to others, and to creation. Spirituality is the spiritual practice of living out our Christian faith. Saint Arnold did ordinary things in an extraordinary manner. God speaks to us in the lives of the saints in very diverse and often unexpected ways. It was so with Saint Arnold. Once Saint Arnold told his spiritual daughters in the cloister on Christmas Day in 1898, "Saints are not born, but gradually are formed by grace." This piece of wisdom is typical of Arnold's basic spiritual orientation and conviction. Arnold was deeply convinced that the success of his work was God's doing, not his. Arnold wrote to brothers in China, "The foundation and the continuation of our society has no other cause than the one who is in heaven and guides all the things here below. Our society is characterized by a Trinitarian and incarnation spirituality, and our sharing in this spirituality across our cultural differences has helped to promote unity in our communities. Our interculturality reflects the unity and diversity of the Trinity, and sharing in our common mission and in our communal life reflects the Word becoming flesh. Increasingly, we invite others to share in the spirituality with others, while remaining open to being enriched by the spirituality of our dialogue partners. Elements of our spirituality. SVD spirituality involves three components: a common spiritual or theological vision. A vision inspires the group and unites its members in working towards their common goal, incarnation, divine indwelling, vision of humanity as being called to communion with God. Ways in which this vision is celebrated and socialized by the group. This would include our particular history, customs and traditions, our special prayers and devotions, Trinity, Sacred Heart, Holy Spirit, Mary, Way of the Cross, water our prayer, particular lifestyle and behavior flowing from and appropriate to the vision. This would include our commitment as religious missionaries, a community living in and for mission, living in international communities. We are empowered by the Holy Spirit, who makes us open to God's presence in Word, Eucharist, ourselves, people, events, mission, creation, and so on. Enables us to grow like Christ, to live like Christ, conversion, to love like Christ, compassion, to see like Christ, contemplation. Saint Arnold says, "Missionaries are ambassadors of divine love. They are to make known God's wonderful deeds and establish the kingdom of divine love. Everything is possible by the power of the Holy Spirit's grace. It is not lengthy prayers, but generous deeds that touch God's heart. Even when God's will does not correspond to your own desires, it is always beneficial for you. The missionary is not the light, but reveals the light of Christ." We believe that the deepest and best understanding of this call to mission is expressed in the term dialogue, or more specifically, prophetic dialogue. Faith seekers and people who have no faith community, people who are poor and marginalized, people of different cultures, people of different religious traditions and secular ideologies. Saint Arnold, a man of God and a man of prayer. Saint Arnold was, in the best sense, a man of God and a man of prayer. With an unshakable faith, he lived consciously in the presence of God and was aware that he was responsible to God. His search to fulfill this God-given task urged him to put in all his energy, taught him unexpected prudence, gave him a worldwide vision, and provided him with courage, strength, and perseverance. animated with a passion for the honor of God and the salvation of peoples, he accomplished much more than his capabilities would suggest. Effective proclamation of the good news. Arnold considered a thorough knowledge of other religions, cultures, and languages an indispensable prerequisite for an effective proclamation of the good news. At this time, that was an exception among missionary congregations. Today, these studies are considered essential by all missionary institutes for the inculturation of the gospel and for dialogue with other religions. This concern has not lost its relevance today. The significance of Arnold's life and work for today. Along with Saint Arnold and all other members of three congregations lived a life of poverty and solidarity with the still poorer people of that time. Thus, the Universal Church's option for the poor finds in Arnold Johnson an enduring model. Courageous opposition to political and industrial oppression of the poor remains relevant today. Multicultural thinking of effective witness. From the beginning, Saint Arnold was open to accepting candidates from all nationalities, and he wanted them to live in communities made up of different nationalities, which was unusual in his day. Today, in an ever-growing multicultural world filled with numerous ethnic conflicts in many countries, international teams of missionaries who live and work together in harmony can be a powerful response to today's tensions and conflicts between different nationalities and ethnic groups. Saint Arnold ahead in his thinking in many other aspects. Other aspects of the relevance of the life and work of Saint Arnold Johnson for today include his effective use of the media, his deep appreciation for the contribution of the laity in missionary activity, his promotion of retreats, especially for lay people, and his firm conviction that all missionaries must first live by the word of God in order to preach it effectively. Saint Arnold Johnson, a model for us. Saint Arnold finds a deep love for the word of God, an intense passion to be instruments of God's will. Saint Arnold was a living testimony that the kingdom is open to all, no matter what the race, culture, or language, or way of life. His openness was also able to include all, seeing in legitimate differences a source of enrichment, even in spite of the difficulties that can sometimes result. Saint Arnold held up the spiritual ideal that the best form of devotion to the Sacred Heart of Jesus is to make our wishes conform to those of the heart of Christ. As Jesus, we should live our lives not for own honor and glory, but according to God's will and for His glory. Vatican Document 2, Nostra Aetate says, "The Catholic Church rejects nothing which is true and holy in these religions." Saint Arnold did not exclude anyone, but included all people dear to the heart of Jesus. Where did Arnold get the light and strength for so many missionary initiatives that are still relevant today? First of all, he was a man of prayer and close union with God. Just as the contemporary church does in its striving for renewal, Arnold Johnson laid emphasis on following the incarnate word and openness to the Holy Spirit, as we see in the names of his congregations, and a life of complete trust in God, our merciful Father. Arnold Johnson was an outstanding devotee of the Blessed Trinity. Like him, the Church today increasingly emphasizes that ecclesial communities are grounded in the triune God and must be mission-oriented. We can therefore say that the spirituality of Arnold Johnson, despite its expression through the popular devotions of his time, is rooted in a genuine Christian spirituality which is still relevant for our multicultural world. Question to ponder over. The motto prayers of Saint Arnold highlight the mystery of the indwelling of the triune God in our hearts. How does this mystery influence your approach to your ministry? From your experience, what elements or aspects of our spirituality sustain you in your missionary commitment? What makes you come alive? As a missionary committed to the Word, do I nurture and pass on Saint Arnold's passion for the Word? Oxford Dictionary gives the meaning of the word spiritual, connected with human spirit rather than the body or physical things. It is a relationship between God and human in a deeper manner and in the heart level. It does not depend on the time that you spent in chapel or the long prayers you do in front of others. In spirituality, it is required to open our hearts to God. You and me cannot judge the spirituality of others, as it is the inner core connection of God with one's deepest feeling of heart. Saint Arnold's life has to do something to say to us today. We live in a multicultural and multi-religious world that compels people from the farthermost ends of the earth to learn to live together side by side. This is the man who became the head of more than 10,000 men and women religious and lay partners from every corner of the world in carrying out the great mission of spreading the good news. If Saint Arnold was able to do it, why can't we? Let's say it together. May the darkness of sin and night of unbelief vanish before the light of word and the spirit of grace. And may the heart of Jesus live in the hearts of all people. Amen.